In this video, I'm going to be showing you Agile Form Planary for Revit, an add-in for Revit that allows you to convert simple sketches inside of Revit into buildings, and then how to assign uses for building spaces, track land use and area distribution from a single building to a master plan. Then I'm going to be showing you how you can evaluate your proposed development, get statistics in real time, and save weeks of work. We're going to be getting data such as parking spaces, FSI, GFA, NSA, and much more. Also, I'm going to be showing you how you can place your model in a realistic setting and generate a map. And then I'm also going to be showing you how you can bring all of this data back into Revit and export all of the statistics as an Excel file. Let's go. Now, if you would like to check out Planary for yourself, there is a 30-day free trial. You can sign up in the cards above and then also down in the link in the description. Also, there is an educational license available for free. So if you're a student, that's something worth checking out. And full disclosure, this is a sponsored video. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. Now, as you can see here on the screen, I already have something and it may look very odd. However, what we have here is basically one outline, which is just a simple property line outlining our property. Now, you create this by going here to Massing Insight and using the property line. Now, the rest of these are simple filled regions. So you can see we have different types with different colors, and I've used these to outline individual buildings or individual areas on our site. Now, those are created here on the annotate tab. We have region and then just use filled region, and that's pretty much it. So with just this information, we can get started in Planary. So I'm going to go here onto add-ins and then find Agile Form Panel and click on Planary, which is just going to start up Planary. And as you can see, it has started. Now here, I'm just going to go to view just to show you. Here we have a couple of options. So the project tree can be turned on and off. Just make sure it's turned on so you can well see it. And then the same thing goes for analysis, which is this part here, which you can also turn on and off. I prefer to have it turned on. And then in Revit, I'm just going to move this a little bit off to the side like that, so we can see both Revit and Planary at the same time. And also, just to mention, I'm using the version 3.0.3. Okay, and now to get started, I'm just going to come here to the center. It says right click to get started. So you just right click and then you add the site. So for the site, I'm just going to be adding this property line. So you just select the property line and then bring back Planary up. And as you can see, we have that property loaded in. Now for this property, you can name it. So let's just call this property area. And we have named it. We can add some comments. We can add offset from ground. I'm not going to do that. And then here we have the site area. And already here in the analysis, you can see some of these fields are starting to be filled out. But as we add more buildings and give more information, we're going to get more analysis. So to add the first building, I'm going to select the property and then right click and click on add building. Now we need to specify the building here in Revit. So that will be this filled region here. So I'm just going to click on that, bring back Planary. And here we go. Now you can navigate around. You use the left mouse click to pan around, right mouse click to orbit around, and then your scroll wheel to zoom in and out. Now keep in mind that this is actually a live link. So here we have this building. However, if I go back to Revit and select this filled region and change its dimensions in any way, well, when we go back to Planary, as you can see, it will automatically update. So basically a live link. If I go back, as you can see, it goes back to the original shape in Planary. So any changes that you make in Revit will immediately apply in Planary, and then you can follow the analysis to see how those changes affect all of your data. So for this first building, let's name it retail. And then for the site, because we have created it on this site, it figured that out. So it's called property area. Then we have the building name, which I'm going to name it, let's say tower. And then for the number of floors, let's go with 5 floors, and the floor height we can set to 4, just like this. So now let's go down. For use, I'm going to set this to retail, and then for section, let's pick out Tower A. So you may have noticed, as soon as I've set this to retail, it changed into this color, which is just the color for our retail building. And then we also have this underground checkbox, which you can check on and off. Now, it's useful if you have some underground structures like parking garages or something like that. In this case, I'm building up, so just leave that checked off. And now, as you can see here, we have already much more information in the analysis, so you can go through total floor area, gross floor area, site area, floor space index, and so on and so forth. And also we have the area distribution, so we have that, so we can just look through that and observe all of these analyses as we build our model. So now let's continue, but actually let's build on top of this building. So some buildings are not just simple extrusions. You might have a few floors that are larger and then perhaps another part of the building that's a bit smaller. So in that case, what you would do is you would simply select this building, right click, and then go to add building part above. So you just click on that and then you select, in this case, I'm just going to select this building part. And now what you'll notice is it just, well, it added it that on top. So here, what I'm going to do is for this one, I'm just going to go with the same name and pretty much the same options. Now here, instead of 5 levels, let's go with 3 levels, and then the floor height will set at 3. And then for use, I'm going to go with retail as well. And then the section will, of course, also be Tower A. And there we go. So now we have completed this first building. Now to continue, let's do the second one, which is this kind of weirdly shaped one off to the side. So for that one, I'm not going to select the site. I'm just going to click in empty space, then right click and go to add building. And I can simply select this weirdly shaped building, go back, and then here in Planary, what I'm going to do now is just fill out the info. So this I can, let's call it shopping mall. Then for the site, as you can see, site is not selected just because I have not selected the site and then went to add building. I just went in empty space. So that's why we can assign the site manually like this from the drop menu. We have the offset from ground, which I'm just going to leave at 0. For the building name, let's call this one shopping mall as well. Then for the number of floors, let's go with 4 floors, and then the floor height will be 3.5. The use, I'm going to set at retail for now, and then let's call this one section podium. Now, let's say I don't want this to be also retail. I want it to be different from this one. So let's say we want to create a new use option as a shopping mall. So for that, you can go here to options, go to preferences, and then we have project units, which you can customize if you want. But more importantly for us now, we have building spaces. And then here we have the existing building spaces, and I can add a new one. So let's call this one shopping. I can pick out a color. So let's go with red. And then here we can check what to include. So I'm just going to leave it as is like this, hit save, and there we go. Now, if I go back here to use, I have shopping. So I can pick that out. As you can see now, this is red because that's the color we've picked out. And we have now customized our use. Moving forward, let's add another building. So I want to add this building here. So I'm just going to select our site, right click, go to add building, and then pick this one out. Then let's set it up. So for the name, and this one will be retail as well. And then for the site, leave it as is. Obviously it's on the same property area. For the building name, let's call this one business block. Then for floors, let's do 3 floors of 3.5. And then the use is going to be retail, and the section, I'm just going to set it at podium like this. And yeah, that's pretty much it for this building. Then moving forward, let's now add some land. So you can specify which type of land is where, and we're going to be doing that now. So let's select our site, our property area, right click, and then go to add land. Now I'm going to pick this filled region here, just like that. And then as you can see, it's going to appear over here as land. Now I'm just going to rename it. I actually want it to be greenery. And then for the thickness, let's make it smaller. So let's go with 0.2. And for the use, set it at greenery. And now it's going to look like that. Now I'm just checking out the analysis here, and I do seem to have a problem, which is parking. So definitely for this property, we have no parking spaces and we need at least 287. So let's now add some parking in form of a parking garage. So for that, I'm just going to select our property area again, go to add building, right click, add building, then select this filled region over here. So we can have overlapping filled regions, that's no problem. And when we open up Planary, now, as you can see, it's obviously overlapping. That's perfectly fine. So for the name, let's call this one garage. And then for the building part, it can be garage as well. For the number of floors, I don't think we need 5 floors. I think 2 will be enough. And then the floor height can be 2.9, I think, for the garage. So for the use, I'm going to set this to parking. And then for section, I'm going to pick underground. And it's still poking out on top. And that's because we need to check on underground here to have it actually be underground. And there we go. So now we have the underground parking, and we can see over here that we have more than enough parking spaces for this property. And also something really useful is the project tree. So it's located over here, so you can basically see how this whole thing comes together. So we have our property area, which is kind of the main thing, and then we have retail, which has this one tower and this additional building part. So that's this one over here. This is the main tower, and this is kind of the whole thing. And then we have our shopping mall, which is this building. Then we have retail, which is this building. And for all of these, we can check them on and off. And as you can see, it's going to affect the analysis. So you can quickly do kind of A/B testing with kind of, do you want to have this part of the building? Do you not want to have it? And then how will that affect the analysis? So I find this really, really useful. And also something that you'll notice is as you select items in Planary, it's going to select them in Revit as well, which is really cool. Now it's time to actually integrate our project on the actual site. So let's do that. So down here we have some options. So currently it's set to none, but if I click here, it's going to allow me to search for the address. So I know I want this to be in my hometown, so I'm just going to search for Belgrade, hit enter. So here, yeah, Belgrade, Serbia. So for example, that's pretty much, yeah, here. And now I'm just going to zoom in. As you can see, you can kind of pan orbit around the map, you can pan around, zoom in. So here I'm just going to search for the position where I want to have this. I can also switch to satellite view, which might make it a bit easier for me. And here we go. I want to have it here. As you can see, we have this empty lot. So let me just expand this a little bit. Yeah, there we go. And we have this empty lot, and let's place our building there. So let's go here to place marker on map, and then we can place our building. Now, as you can see, kind of the building origin is over here, or the base point. Now we can actually change that by going here to change site base point, and then in Revit we can assign it. So I just want to place it here at this corner, just like that. And then going back here into Planary, as you can see, it has moved. And now we can place marker on map again. So I'm just going to place it like that. And now I do need to give it some rotation. So let's see, what does this look like? Yeah, we're almost there. So yeah, I think this works really, really well. So there we go. We have placed this now on our map. We can view it in this mode with just kind of the 3D, which I really like actually. But then also we have the satellite overlay, which also looks really, really good. Next, I'm going to be showing you how you can export all of this analysis data into an Excel spreadsheet. But before that, let's see how we can export this mass back into Revit. So for that, let's go here to File and then to Export and export this mass into Revit. Now I'm just going to call this one Planary Mass, place it on level 1, click OK, and now it's going to do its process of converting that planary geometry into Revit massing. And here we go. So this is what we have. I can try to view this in realistic view mode. There we go. So this mask has now been brought in, and we can use this to continue working on our model, kind of skipping this step of creating the masses ourselves. Just because we've done this through planary, we now have all of that created. Now, apart from exporting the mass itself, which is cool, we can also export something which is really useful, and that is the analysis. So what we can do is we can go here to File, Export, and then export an Excel data file, and then we can just specify where we want to place it. So let's call this one Massing Study -1, hit Save, and now we have that Excel file. So if I just open it up, this is what that looks like. As you can see, it's beautifully formatted. We have a 3D view, which is nice. And then here we have all of that important data. So we have our general information, our property area, building breakdown, total floor area breakdown, so on and so forth. So a lot of information here. And then you can share this to other people that are perhaps not working in Revit, and making file sharing a lot simpler and easier. And this is where we're going to be concluding this video. I hope you have enjoyed it. Again, as I said, if you want to check out Planary, you can check out the free trial. I'm going to leave a link up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. And also, if you're a student, they now offer student licenses as well. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.